Man, I love that song. Hello, everybody, and welcome to another incredible week of Freeze Frame. Joining me this week is Miles Ward. Hey, I'm glad you could join us today.
I'm glad to be here.
During Freeze Frame, we've been learning all about the miracles of Jesus and discovering what it's like to have the power of Jesus in our life. So far, we have learned how Jesus calmed the storm, and last week we learned how Jesus cast out many demons from a man. Only Jesus can perform miracles because he is all-powerful.
Hey, speaking of power, would you like to see a cool power that I have?
Well, yeah.
Would you believe that with one small command, I can raise things into the air without touching them?
Well, no, you can't. Are you sure?
Oh, you don't think so?
Well,
then prepare to be amazed.
Okay.
This is a simple little ping pong ball.
Okay.
There are no strings attached to this ball.
Okay.
I don't know this ping pong ball. In fact, we've never met. Let me prove it to you. Ping pong ball, have we met? If the answer is no, say nothing. Told you so. Now, with just one small command, I will raise this ping pong ball up. Are you ready to be amazed?
I guess.
I'm going to need more enthusiasm than that.
Okay.
Let's try it again. Are you ready to be amazed?
I'm ready.
Then with no further ado, ping pong ball, I say to you, get up. Maybe it didn't hear me. Let me say it more loudly this time.
Okay.
Ping pong ball, I say to you, get up. That's weird.
Mm.
I know it heard me that time. Maybe we both need to say it.
Okay.
On the count of three, shout the command with me. One, two, three.
Ping pong ball, I say to you, get up.
I guess you were right. There's no way I can raise this ping pong ball up with just one command. But do you know who can? Jesus.
That's right.
In fact, he did. Except when Jesus did it, it wasn't just a ping pong ball. It was a girl.
Mm.
And she wasn't just lying in my hand. She was dead. Sounds pretty awesome, right? It is. Let's check it out ourselves.
Why don't you put that away? Maybe you can find another way to get that thing to raise later, okay? All right, here we go. Today's big Bible story is from the book of Mark in the New Testament. It is called Jesus Heals Jairus' Daughter. Miles has agreed to wear the freeze frame box and help us with some expressions. Maybe we should practice first. Let's see how this fits on you, okay? Here, you hold on to it on the sides. Get your face right on up there, okay? Let's see you making your silliest face. Ready? 3, 2, 1, freeze. That's a good one. All right, I think we're ready. All right, here we go. Last week we heard how Jesus healed a man who had some evil spirits inside of him. After Jesus healed the man, he sailed with his disciples to the other side of the sea. When he got there, a man named Jairus fell at his feet. He had a very sad face. You ready? 3, 2, 1, freeze. Yep, he had a sad face. Jairus had tears in his eyes. He said, "My little daughter is dying. Please come and heal her." So Jesus went with him. As Jesus was walking to Jairus' house, a huge crowd of people followed him. One of the people was a woman who had been sick and suffering for 12 years. She had spent every last penny on doctors, but no one could make her better. When she saw Jesus, she thought, "Maybe if I just touch his clothes, I'll be healed." So that's what she did. And immediately her sickness and suffering went away. When the woman touched Jesus' clothes, Jesus could feel that power had gone out of him. So he turned around and asked, "Who touched my clothes?" Let's see a confused look. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Confused. Jesus' disciples couldn't figure out why he was asking that. The crowd was pressed all around him. Lots of people had touched his clothes. Still, Jesus kept looking to see who had done it. The woman knew that Jesus was looking for her. She shook with fear, but told Jesus the whole truth. Let's see a scared face now. Ready? 3, 2, 1, freeze! Yep, she was scared. When he heard what had happened, Jesus said, "Your faith has healed you. You are now free from your suffering." Just then, some people came from Jairus' house and said, "Jairus, your daughter is dead." Jesus said, "Don't be afraid, Jairus. Just have faith." When they got to Jairus' house, Jesus could hear all the people wailing and crying inside. So he went in and said, "Why are you so sad? The girl isn't dead. She's just sleeping." When the people heard what Jesus said, they laughed at him because they thought he was nuts. Let's ready. Let's see a laughing face. Ready? 3, 2, 1, freeze. They all laughed at him. But that didn't stop Jesus, though. He took the girl by the hand and said to her, "Little girl, I say to you, get up." Immediately the girl came to life again. She stood up and began walking around like she had just gotten up from a nap. When everyone saw what Jesus did, they were shocked. Let's see a shocked look. 3, 2, 1, freeze. Yep, they were shocked. They were shocked because they had never seen anything like it. Because of Jairus' faith in Jesus, his daughter was alive again. We just heard of two miracles Jesus performed. Let's now watch a video of today's story together.
Jesus got into a boat and crossed the Sea of Galilee. He stood on the shore and a large crowd gathered around him. Then Jairus, one of the rulers in the synagogue, fell at Jesus' feet and begged for his help. "My daughter is about to die. Please come touch her so she will be healed and live," he said. Jesus went with Jairus, and many people followed, crowding around him. In the crowd was a woman who had been bleeding for 12 years. She had seen many doctors and spent all her money, but no one could help her. She was getting worse. The woman had heard about Jesus, so she came up behind him in the crowd and touched his clothes. She said to herself, "If I touch even his clothes, I will be healed." As soon as she touched Jesus' clothes, her bleeding stopped and she knew she was healed. At that moment, Jesus felt that power had gone out of him. He turned around and said, "Who touched my clothes?" Jesus' disciples pointed out that many people were crowded around him, but Jesus kept looking around. The woman, knowing she was healed, came forward and fell before Jesus. She told him what had happened. Jesus said to her, "Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace. You are healed." While Jesus was speaking, some men came from Jairus' house and said, "Your daughter is dead. Do not bother Jesus anymore." Jesus heard what the men said, and he told Jairus, "Do not be afraid, just believe." Jesus and three of his disciples went to Jairus' house. The people there were crying and wailing loudly. Jesus said, "Why are you crying? The child is not dead. She is sleeping." The people laughed at Jesus, and he told them all to go. Jesus took Jairus and his wife into the room where the child was. He took the girl by the hand and said, "Little girl, get up." Immediately, the girl got up and began walking around. Jairus and his wife were amazed. Jesus told them to give the girl some food and to not tell anyone what had happened. By healing the woman and raising the little girl from the dead, Jesus showed his power as the Messiah. Jesus died on the cross and rose again to save people from sin and death. When we trust in Jesus, God forgives our sin and changes us to be more like his Son.
In our story for today, Jesus didn't just raise up an itty-bitty ping pong ball. He raised up a girl from the dead.
That's right.
When Jesus got to the house, She was just lying there, completely still. No life in her, just like this ping pong ball. But that was no big thing for Jesus. To him, it was just like she was taking a nap. He took the little girl by the hand and said, "Little girl, I say to you, get up." And just like that, the little girl rose from the dead. She stood up and began to walk around. And
oh, you gonna show us how?
Kind of like this. And if you think a floating ping pong ball is amazing, imagine how the people in Jairus' house felt. They had just watched Jesus bring a dead girl back to life.
Boy, that was amazing. And that's not the only time that Jesus raised someone from the dead. He raised two other people from the dead too. And don't forget, Jesus himself was raised from the dead by God. And there was a whole bunch of times that he healed people from sickness. Jesus can do that because he has power over sickness and death. When we're sick or when someone we know is sick, Jesus wants us to come to him, just like the sick woman and Jairus did in today's Bible story. He wants us to pray and to have faith that he can heal us. Do you think that means that Jesus will heal everybody from their sickness? Maybe, but maybe not right away, but eventually. Sometimes people pray to be healed, but they stay sick. That doesn't mean that Jesus won't ever heal them. It might be later in life that Jesus heals them. It might even be after their life in heaven that Jesus heals them. That's what our Bible verse for today talks about. Miles, will you say it with me? Let's take a look at it together.
He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death, and there will be no more sadness. There will be no more crying or pain. Revelation 21, 4a.
Very good. If you have faith in Jesus and follow him, when you die, he will raise you back to life in heaven. In heaven, Jesus will wipe away all of your tears. He will take away all of your sadness. He will heal you from all of your sickness. So if you are sick or if someone you know is sick, pray to Jesus with a big faith and ask him for healing. But if you or the person who is sick doesn't get better right away, don't be discouraged. Jesus hears your prayer. And he will bring total healing in this life or in heaven.
Our big idea this week says Jesus has power over sickness and death. So we can pray to him for healing.
That's right. Maybe there's someone you know of right now that is sick and needing healing. Let's pray together and ask God to heal them. But remember to trust God with how he wants to do the healing. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for this time together. I thank you for my friend Miles who's come to help today. And today we've looked at some stories of how you did some healing, where you healed a woman that was sick and then you brought a little girl back to life. We're reminded that you have all power and that you can do anything and that nothing is too difficult for you. We all have been sick and we know people who have been sick and we know people who have died also. And to be honest, Lord, we sometimes don't understand why some people have to die, not in this life at least. But we know that when we pray and that we ask you to bring healing to someone, that you'll do it in the best way, whether here on earth or in heaven someday. So help us to have faith like Jairus did and the woman who touched his clothes, to have faith to trust you that whatever the answer is, it is what is best. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Water you turned into wine. Open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you. None like you. Into the darkness you shine. Out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you. Greater, our God is stronger. God, you are high.
It's really good having you here today. I'm so glad you helped me out. It wasn't so bad, was it?
No.
Not too bad. How about, let's do one more face for everybody before we say goodbye today, okay? How about let's do, you know what? Jairus's family and all the people and the woman who'd been sick, they were so happy with what had happened. I think they were surprised that Jesus actually did what he did. So how about let's give it our very best surprise look, okay? Ready? 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Hey, see you next week, guys, on Freeze Frame. Bye-bye.